Welcome to my channel Gaurang the Motivator. In my last class, I had discussed about electric charge. Okay, so now in this session, I am going to talk about electric current. Okay, so what is electric current? Electric means we know it is related to the charges, and the current represents to, in general, the meaning of current is flow. Flow, or we can also call it as motion. So in general, current means flow or motion. Suppose there is flow of water, we call it as water current. The air, that is air current. In the same way, here electric current means the flow of charges in general. Okay, now let's go in depth. Let's take an example. This is a copper wire. We have a copper wire and its two terminals A and B. So there are charges present in any particle, correct? So charges are present in all the particles. So this is a copper wire. We call it as a conductor also, which allows the flow of charges. Now in this, let's take few charges. Here we have charges, one or two examples, electrons and so on. Okay, so these are the charges. These charges move from one end of the terminal to the other end terminal. Okay, from A to B. When they flow, they take some time. Okay, they take some time to move from A to B. Okay, so the flow of charges, they are moving means it is nothing but flow of charges. Okay, flow of charges, and to flow from terminal A to terminal B, they require certain time. Okay, so in short, we can define electric current as rate of flow of charge. Okay, so it defines the same example what I have given to you right now. So rate refers to the time. Okay, rate of flow of charge. So these are the charges. The charges move from one terminal to another terminal. This rate of flow of charge is itself known as electric current. So the symbol of electric current is I. We represent electric current by the symbol I. Okay, the SI unit of electric current is ampere, ampere. Okay, this is the SI unit of electric current. Now this electric current is a scalar quantity. Okay, scalar quantity, we have studied it in lower classes. Scalar quantities are those quantities which have only magnitude and no directions. So the flow of charges do not have any particular directions. So we consider this rate of flow of charges to be a scalar quantity. Therefore we call electric current as a scalar quantity. Now the formula used to calculate electric current is I is equals to charges. We say charges Q by T. So this by T is nothing but rate is nothing but time. Okay, so current I is equals to Q by T, rate of charges that flow. Okay, so in a circuit, rate of flow of charge is known as electric current, and it's given by the formula I is equals to Q by T. Now here we should know that I is current in amperes. Okay, and Q is charge charge in coulomb and T is time in seconds. Time in seconds. Okay? So, my dear students, this is very important. Every quantity, either it might be current, charge or time, okay, any quantities, we must always try to mention them in the SI units, because further it helps us to solve the sums. Even in the numericals, we need to keep all the quantities in their respective SI units. Okay, so this is about electric current. Now let's move on further. To measure this electric current, we need some instrument. So the instrument used to measure electric current, okay, instrument that we use to measure electric current is ammeter, A-M-M-E-T-E-R. Ammeter is an instrument used to measure electric current, okay. This instrument ammeter is always connected in series. About series and parallel connection, we will be talking in our future topics. So, just you should know that this instrument ammeter, which is used to measure electric current, is always connected in series, because this ammeter has load resistance. This instrument has low resistance. Okay? Low resistance. Okay? Sometimes in the board examination, a question comes, define the SI unit of electric current. So, the question will be something like this. Define the SI unit of electric current. Okay? So this will be the question sometimes. Define the SI unit of electric current. So we know what is electric current. We studied the formula of electric current, I is equals to Q by T, correct? So here I represents current in amperes and Q represents charge in coulomb and T represents current in seconds. Now just change this formula to the respective SI units. So I means electric current, its SI unit is ampere. So let's write here ampere, okay, is equals to Q stands for charge in coulombs. So the SI unit is coulomb. Let's write here coulomb divided by time, it is in seconds. Okay? So the question is, define the SI unit of electric current. The SI unit of electric current is ampere. We know. We have to define ampere. So what we can do? 1 ampere is defined as 1 coulomb of charge that flows in 1 second in the circuit. I repeat once again, 1 ampere is defined as 1 coulomb of charge that flows in 1 second in the circuit. So this is known as 1 ampere. So in statement we are going to write it as 1 ampere, okay, 1 ampere is defined as 1 coulomb of charge that flows in 1 second
in a circuit.
Many times you confuse yourself with defined electric current and define the SI unit of electric current. So defined electric current, you are going to write the rate of flow of charges is known as electric current. Okay, its SI unit is ampere, I is equals to Q by T. When it comes to define the SI unit of electric current, you have to write this definition, 1 ampere. So before that, if the question is define the SI unit of electric current, just write the SI unit of electric current is ampere, and after writing that, you write 1 ampere is defined as 1 coulomb of charge that flows in 1 second in a circuit. Okay, students, now let's move on to the numericals on electric current. Let's solve a numerical on electric current. So the formula what we use to calculate electric current is I is equals to Q by T. Keeping this in mind, here's a sum. A current of 0.5 ampere is drawn by a filament of an electric bulb for 10 minutes. Find the amount of electric charge that flows through the circuit. Children, we need to read the question again and again to understand. Yeah, numericals are not difficult. Only understanding of the given question is the most important part. Okay? And here, when we read the question, that is why I always suggest you to write given. Okay, so let's start this sum. Okay, writing the given. So in the question, it is said a current of 0.5 ampere. Current, the symbol represented for current is I. I is equals to 0.5 ampere. Okay. A is the short form of ampere. So we have to see that the quantity, given quantities are in SI units or not. If they are not, we need to convert them into SI units. So we need not worry about current because it's already in SI unit. So now a current of 0.5 amp is drawn by a filament of an electric bulb for 10 minutes. So this minutes is related to time, correct? So we will write here, time is equals to 10 minutes. 10 minutes. Now children, this minutes is not the SI unit of time. The SI unit of time is seconds. So we need to convert these minutes into seconds. How to convert? We are multiplying 10 minutes into number of seconds. That will be equal to 600 seconds. Right? 600 seconds. So time in SI units, that is 10 minutes in SI units, is 600 seconds. Next, therefore, find the amount of electric charge. Find electric charge. Charge is nothing but Q. The symbol of electric charge is Q. So this is what we need to find. Okay? So now I will write here, instead of 10 minutes, I will directly write here 600 seconds. Okay? I will just write here 600 seconds. So now, let's go to the formula. The formula of electric current is I is equals to Q by T. We need only Q. So, which implies that keeping Q here itself, I into T. Transform the T from denominator, it goes to the numerator. Okay? So now, let's go for the solution. Solution, the formula is Q is equals to I into T. So I is given here 0.5 ampere into time is 600 coulombs. If we multiply this, we get 300 coulombs. Okay, the SI unit of charge is coulomb, so we can write it as 300 coulombs. Children, it is better you multiply it and check it out. I'll do the rough work here. Okay, so 600 into 0.5. Okay, so multiply this. 5 zeros are 0s are 30 and 0 0 0 0 0 0 3 after one digit here comes. So 300.0, which can be written as 300 coulomb. So we can write here the result. Result is important. Okay, find the amount of electric charge that flows. So therefore, the amount of electric charge that flows through the circuit, flows through the circuit is 300 coulomb. Okay, so this is how we are solving the numericals. Let's move on to the second numerical on electric current. Here's the question. Calculate the current supplied by a cell if the amount of charge passing through the cell in 2 minutes is 240 coulombs. So let's write the given part. Calculate the current. So we can write here I is equals to question mark. Okay. By a cell, if the amount of charge passing through the cell in 2 minutes, 2 minutes refers to time, so we'll write here time is 2 minutes. Now children, I told you we have to judge whether it is in SI units, so it's not in SI unit. Minutes is not the SI unit of time, seconds is the SI unit of time, so 2 minutes can be written as 2 into 60 seconds, that is 120 seconds, right? So time is 120 seconds in its SI unit form and is 240 coulombs. So charge Q is equals to 240 coulombs. So this is in the SI unit form itself. So this is what given in the question. Now the formula what we are using to calculate the electric current, we already are familiar. I is equals to Q by T, right? Now we'll go for the solution. In solution, write the equation I is equals to Q by T. The formula, substitute Q value we have 240 coulombs divided by T. T, the time what we have calculated in its SI unit form is 120 seconds. Okay, so I is equals to 0 cancel, 12 ones are 12, 2s are 24. We got it as 2 ampere. Okay, so therefore the current supplied by a cell is 2 ampere. Okay, that's what we have tried in the result. Therefore the current supplied by a cell current supplied by the cell
sir. 2 amps.
Okay, so my dear children, we'll continue with the next topic, that is electric potential, in my next video, in my next session. Till then, stay tuned to my channel Gaurang the Motivator. Please subscribe, like, share and comment. Thank you.